So Apple just concluded its annual iPhone announcement, and today I want to go over the highlights of this event. So before I get started, I just want to preface this video by saying that this is not going to be an in-depth on every single thing that was announced. This video is going to be a highlights reel of everything that was talked about at the event. And what I'm going to do is, later this evening, I'm going to upload more detailed videos about all of the different products that were announced. So there's going to be a video for the Apple Watch Series 4, as well as for the iPhone XS's and the iPhone XR. So without any further ado, let's hop into this video. So the event centered around two of Apple's most personal devices, as they claim, the Apple Watch and the iPhone. So we'll start with the Apple Watch because that's what Apple announced first. Now, unless you've been living under a rock, you probably heard some murmurs about what the new Apple Watch is going to look like. So this was the first time since its inception that the Apple Watch design has changed. Basically, the whole design got iPhone 10-ified with a larger screen and smaller bezels. The 38mm screen was bumped up to 40, and the 42 was bumped up to 45. This means we have 30 and 35% larger screens. As far as the rest of the design, it's not a huge departure from what you all know an Apple Watch looks like. It's a little bit more curved, and the materials have changed on the back of the device. They're now completely made out of black ceramic and sapphire crystal. So as far as other updates, they're mainly under the hood. So these speaker and microphone were improved to help with Hey Siri commands. So one of the other important features is new fall detection. Basically, they mapped the patterns that we all take when we take a tumble, and basically the Apple Watch can detect it and will alert emergency services. Basically, it's Life Alert, but in an Apple Watch. So they kind of just put Life Alert out of business, I guess. In keeping with their health and safety theme, they introduced new upgrades to the optical heart rate sensor. Now, this sensor isn't new. It's been on the Apple Watch since its inception, but it has been updated to give you alerts if your heart rate is too low or if your heart rhythm is irregular, called atrial fibrillation. And of course, the Series 4 includes a new S4 chip, which is supposedly twice as fast as the outgoing S3 chip from last year's Apple Watch. And the final notable change was that the digital crown, which has always kind of been a little bit overlooked, in my opinion, on the Apple Watch, has now been updated with more useful haptic feedback. So pricing for this is going to be $400 for the GPS-only model and $500 for GPS plus cellular. And of course, the prices can go up from there with larger screens and fancier bands. Additionally, it is worth noting that the Series 3 sticks around at a new lower price point of $280. Okay, so moving on to the iPhone. Unless you've been living under a rock, you probably had some idea of what iPhones were going to be announced. So the first ones that Apple talked about were the XS and XS Max. Now, despite its silly name, the XS Max is actually quite an interesting device, but basically it's a supersized version of the iPhone X. Now, both of these phones are pretty incremental updates. You know, as the name would imply, a XS, it's an incremental under-the-hood update, so the design isn't really any different, although there is a new gold color that was added. So the new iPhones are IP68 water-resistant, they have a pixel density of 458 pixels per inch, and the displays have been upgraded over the iPhone X's OLED display to feature 60% greater dynamic range of colors than the old model. So the iPhone X is actually quite an interesting device because, well, it's an absolute mammoth, a 6.5-inch OLED display. The form factor isn't any different from a Plus iPhone, so the iPhone 6, 6S, 7, and 8 Plus. They're all the same size, and the iPhone XS Max doesn't increase the size anymore. It just increases the amount of real estate that is dedicated to the screen. And of course, powering these new devices is an incremental step up to the A12 Bionic chip, which offers a 6-core processor that increases performance about 15% over the A11 that was used in last year's iPhones. On the other hand, the GPU sees 50% increases and is now a 4-core system. Storage tiers have also been changed. We now have 64, 256, and a new 512GB option. Prices start at $999 for the iPhone XS and bump up to $1099 for the XS Max. So, moving on to the iPhone XR. Basically, this is, as Apple called it, the iPhone X experience on an LCD iPhone. So there are a couple of areas where this is a step down from the iPhone XS. We are using aluminum instead of stainless steel. We're using an LCD, what they call a liquid retina display, but that's really just a normal LCD display instead of an OLED. And the pixel density is down to 326 from 458 on the XS. Size-wise, the new phone kind of sits right in the middle at a 6.1-inch display. And while it does have thicker bezels, they're still a lot thinner than you'll find on older iPhones. And it's going to be a little bit smaller than an iPhone Plus, but a little bit bigger, of course, than an iPhone 8. As far as what's powering it, we have the same Face ID from the iPhone X, and we also have this same A12 Bionic chip that's found on the XS and XS Max. One other important thing to note is that the iPhone XS and XS Max keep 3D Touch, where the iPhone XR no longer uses that. Instead, it opts for haptic touch, which is basically the same technology that you'll find on a MacBook trackpad. There are also some very interesting camera improvements. We're now shooting with a 12 megapixel sensor, and it can now shoot portrait mode even though it's just a single camera system. So portrait mode is now going to be standard across all new iPhones. Also, standard is Bluetooth 5.0 across all the different iPhones and the Apple Watch Series 4. So pricing for the iPhone XR is $749 to start, and that'll get you 64 gigabytes. From there, you can jump up to 128 and 256. And there are now new color options. We now have white, black, blue, coral, and yellow. So no gold on the iPhone XR. You're gonna have to jump up to the S or S Max if you want that option. And lastly, iOS 12 is going to be released on September 17th, and macOS Mojave will be coming to us on September 24th. Ooh, so those are the highlights, what I think are the most important things about the new iPhones. Of course, there's a lot more to go into, so I encourage you to subscribe and stick around for later today when I come out with videos that kind of go into more detail and get a little bit more of my thoughts and opinions on the new iPhones and the new Apple Watch. Those will be coming at you later tonight. But for now, make sure to follow me on Twitter at Luke Miani. Don't forget to join my subreddit. The link is in the description below. And I will see you guys in the next video.